guess someday the truth come out. You uptown friends, don't you all about? One day the truth come out, little mama. Parked outside the cemetery gates, little mama. Yeah, I'm parked outside the cemetery gates, little mama. I'm parked outside the cemetery gates. Hope in the end you learn not to hate. Parked outside the cemetery gates, little mama. Talk about the wind and the rain, little mama. Yeah, well, we used to talk about the wind and the rain, little mama. Yeah, well, we used to talk about the wind and the rain. Now just want to live to see again. We used to talk about the wind and the rain, little mama. We used to talk about the wind and the rain, little mama. Sunset in Orange over Tulsa tonight, and the sky's filling up with stars. The kids here smoking Marlboro Reds in the chain light behind the bar. She drills on the outskirts of town, find nothing that your heart desires. That's a fine dress to hide your regrets, a belt buckle to the flame you fire.
Let's do it for Johnny,
let's do it one more time. Let's do it for Johnny, we'll make believe one more time you're mine. Well, if you need to be sick, honey, that's alright. Promise I won't watch. If we leave right now, we'll be in Arkansas by morning. Then we can split the cost. Johnny cast him long as a big old truck that rolls silent through the night. The old house, it was well run down by the park where the breezes fight. Let's do it for Johnny, do it one more time. Let's do it for Johnny, make believe one more time you're mine. Let's do it for Johnny, do it one more time. Let's do it for Johnny, oh, make believe one more time that you're mine. Let's do it.
From an undisclosed location deep within the heart of the Ozark Mountains, it's the Spooky Talk Show with Josh the Devil. And here he is now, ladies and gentlemen. Put it, your hands together for Josh the Devil!
Yeah, that intro gets choppier and crappier every week, doesn't it? Yeah! Oh, hey, welcome to Spooky Talk Show. I am Josh the Devil. Now, I'm pretty sure those are last week's cards. There's nothing else on that card that I should read then.
Okay.
Welcome to Spooky Talk Show. I'm Josh the Devil. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, what's going on? Hey, I heard about this. Western Sizzlin' is going out of business. And if you're not upset about it, you probably have a pretty good life. It's probably not too bad. Yeah, get on with your day-to-day, all right. Hey, Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey Circus, they are also closing after 146 years. Wow. A marked increase of creepy, homeless, out-of-work clown sightings is expected. Coming to a town near you. Just standing there looking at you, holding balloons or not. That's creepy. That's creepy. Okay, we are going to move the show right along because I'm just digging a hole to stand in right now. So we're going to bring out our co-host. You know him as the brain behind Brain Trust. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Brown. Michael, how are you?
Welcome. I am very happy. Good.
I forgot to mention, on the show tonight, we have guests. I could mention we have guests.
Oh, yeah. Well, let's mention that we have guests.
All right. Well, who do we have? We've got... an amazing show.
Yes, yeah. This show is so good, you guys.
I'm just drawing this out as long as I can. No, we've got a great musical. You put the gimp back in his room. It's so amazing that I won't finish this joke. No, we have a musical performance later tonight from the P-47's, and they're going to be here to play us at least a couple of songs, as long as we don't throw rocks at them. But we have got a pretty much a legend in the comic world. You can hear him laughing in the background. You can say that, but if you look up your own name and you just look how many different characters this guy has drawn, worked on, both Marvel and DC, we've got, the list just goes on and on. I couldn't read them all here now. So we'll find out a little bit what's in his head. I'm talking about John Lucas. All right. So, Michael, now let's get started. Now, we've got quite a bit. We've got special guests.
That's right.
So we're going to get right into...
Silence!
I'm going to need the gimp to get the large scythe and just...
I thought we took all the captive cell phones away.
I know, that's fine. He's trying to get out. They always do.
That's fine.
Okay, so we're going to jump right into what you guys remember as our weekly thing. It's, of course, our Twitter question. We ask you a question on Twitter, and you give us the worst answers possible, and we read some of them, and then some of them are run through our little process machine, and they come out, and we read what the machine says we should read. Spooky Talk Show on Twitter. We
be
probably
sure and
even have a graphic that says so. All right, so last week we asked you, whose mom's dick are you guys talking about? Right, and if you watch the show, then that'll make sense.
Yeah.
If you don't watch the show, then none of this makes sense anyway.
No.
All right. So number five, we've got the Rock Box 2, the world's most powerful vibrator. Get your box rocked.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
And what else we got?
Number four is the Nirvana dual motor vibrator. With that one, you can come as you are. As you were, as you want me to be.
I'm sensing a theme here. Number three, the Hitachi Magic Wand, available at your local I can't even read your handwriting. Wand shop or wherever magic wands are sold.
It's the Ollivander's wand.
Ollivander's wand shop.
Yeah,
or wherever magic wands are sold.
Hitachi magic wand. The Moby. This is real. The world's largest dildo.
Moby, the world's largest dildo, you say?
Yes, that's right. And his music kind of sucks, too.
Aww. Obviously not a great white whale.
Yeah.
All right. And number one on the top five answers to which mom's dick are we talking about? It's you. Your mom's dick. The viewer. That's right, you. Turn and look at your mom sitting on the couch next to you watching this on YouTube and have the awkward moment where you lock eye contact and you know it's her dick we've been talking about this whole time. All right, anyway, so
okay.
Next week we're going to ask another question, and here it is. You can tweet us your answers at Spooky Talk Show, and the question is...
The top five Obama presidential conspiracies.
All right.
The ones that you enjoy, the one that you think is the most true, go ahead and tweet that at us. We'll throw together a top five list.
That's right. We'll probably ignore everything you say and then put in awful stuff like we just read. All right.
Possibly.
Without further ado, we've got something big planned. Okay?
We really do.
I really pulled out all the stops, if I do say so myself. Last week, if you watched, you'll notice that, or you'll remember that I talked about Isaac Hayes. I'm convinced that it is, in fact, the ghost of Isaac Hayes that's haunting this cabin. I gave my reasons. Now, everybody seemed to think that maybe it was more just the ghost of Chef from South Park haunting the cabin. But regardless, I know it's Isaac Hayes. Nobody believes me, but I know that after tonight, everyone will, in fact, believe me. So my first guest tonight to help me prove my theory, Velveteen Tombstone, R&B psychic. Here he is, Velveteen. How are you, sir? You flew here from Atlantic City. Come on.
I got the spirits all in me.
Oh. Easy, Velveteen.
Oh, easy.
All right. Oh, yeah. So listen. So as we talked a little bit before. You know my thoughts. Coming in, getting an impression of the building. Give me your thoughts.
Well, let's see. Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. Oh, universe, you talking to me. Yeah. Put on your red dress.
Yeah, I think he's getting something.
Slip on your high heels.
He's definitely feeling something.
There's definitely something that's touching me.
There's a soulful
in a way
presence
that
here.
I like.
All right. Yeah. Listen, if that wasn't enough, if that weren't enough, let me change my pants.
It's
touching the gimp. If having Velveteen weren't enough, I have a second expert. That's right. We spared no expense. We flew him all the way here from wherever our guys grabbed him and stuck him in a van. They don't even tell me. We have former Isaac Hayes manager, a producer. Here he is, Chris Cockrell. Chris, thanks so much for being here. I'm not sure where you're supposed to sit, I guess, Michael. We didn't plan this far ahead. Big surprise, I know. Have a seat. Yeah, have a seat right here. Have a seat right here. Can we get maybe a stool over there for Michael, perhaps? I bet we can, or something.
That ain't no stool.
That's it. Yeah.
Good now.
Stool is there. All right, so Chris, thanks for being here. Now, Velveteen, no offense, but there are some that might say that you're just making everything up.
That all of your feelings are just made up.
So I thought, well, all right, on the flip side, we'll get Chris here. Now, Chris, you worked with Isaac for many, many years.
Yes.
On a lot of different projects, South Park and touring and doing shows. So in the studio. So lots of different environments. If we get something that's really personal, some little small bit of knowledge that maybe you know, not the average person would know, then maybe that could be my key and I can win this $50. I mean, I can just, we can just...
for verification.
Yes, for verification that it is, in fact, Isaac Hayes. So, Velveteen, why don't you, we want to hold hands and kind of see if we can feel the room here?
Really?
Sure. All right, get in here.
Get your seance on.
Ooh.
Yes.
All right, this is pretty weird. I'm not gonna lie. Done some weird stuff, but this is.
We feel.
Spent a weekend.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I'm feeling something. Yeah.
There's something here.
Oh.
Oh, hello, children.
Oh, yes. No, is that you, Isaac? Isaac, is that you? Is that you, Isaac Hayes? Haunting our cabin.
Known as Isaac Hayes.
You did this. We have contact. Can you give us some proof?
There is no way that you can disprove this.
Oh, give us some kind of proof. Give us anything. Some kind of personal tidbit. Some information that only you would know.
The beam from Shaft.
You think? Well, yeah. I mean, but yeah, something a little better than that. Come on.
Scientology is awesome.
All right, come on, you're gonna have to do better than that. Something deep, something personal. Something only you would know.
I had a four-way with the Dixie Chicks.
is there a videotape of that?
Can you verify that?
It was before they were famous.
All right, well that, yeah, all right. Come on, you gotta give us something.
My entire life I wanted to hang out in a shitty cabin.
Wait a minute.
That doesn't sound right.
Would Isaac Hayes, hold on.
Wait a minute.
Verification from you, the guy who knew him?
Yeah, what he wanted to hung out in a cabin.
I worked with him for like a year, man.
This was a pretty shitty cabin.
Horseshit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Who are you?
Wait. Whoa.
What?
Whoa.
You got more?
What? Who are you thinking?
The spirits lied to me.
The spirits lied to you? So it's not Isaac Hayes.
Like a dang woman that done me wrong.
Oh, well.
Wait. Hang on. Here and now.
Oh,
no. This talk show is really shitty.
Man. It's Luther Vandross. Damn it! Ah! Every damn time. That's 50. I'm sorry.
I tell you what. You mistook me for Isaac Hayes.
Well, all right, yeah.
I'm never going to haunt this building again.
Oh, man, now Luther Vandross isn't even going to haunt our cabin. All right. I'm sorry, you guys at home.
I think that went well.
It was Luther Vandross, and now even he isn't haunting our cabin. So, all right, well, can we give a big...
Still a presence.
Later. Let's give a big round of applause to Chris Cockrell and Velveteen Tombstone, R&B Psychic.
Man, we spare no expense to verify our hauntings.
I know, $3.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah. Oh, no.
He's getting paid scale. He thinks he's getting paid scale.
You do get Fritos if you can make it all the way to the end of the week.
Scaly Fritos.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, my next guest what were you saying earlier? You're not an artist, you're a
cartoonist,
that's the word. Cartoonist who has worked for independent companies as well as Marvel and DC. So please welcome John Lucas. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for coming. All right, now, John, we met a couple of times at various conventions,
yeah.
And you seemed like a pretty nice guy. I thought, well, he's a good guy. We'll grab him, put the hood on him, stick him in the van, drag him over to the spooky talk show, and pick his brain a minute. So, if that's all right.
Sure.
Okay, so now, run us through kind of your... I hate to go through your just... comic book database of characters, but who are some of the more famous characters you've drawn?
The big one is, well, the one, if anybody knows me, they know me from, where am I supposed to look?
Two.
Deadpool is the one that most people know me
for,
but I've drawn Superman, I've worked on Batman, Spider-Man, geez, Conan the Barbarian.
And you've got some X-Men.
Yeah, yeah, I've worked on the X-Men. I forgot about the X-Men. I've worked on X-Force and
Wolverine.
This yeah,
particular,
yeah, yeah.
A little Punisher because, I saw in there.
Did I work? Yeah, I did work on the Punisher.
There's
I forget
yeah, so
over time.
Many.
Yeah.
I know. So I mean, that's pretty much every character that anyone's ever going to make a movie out of or has made a movie out of.
I suppose
there.
So. Yeah,
so
yeah.
That's a pretty good list. Over the years, you've drawn pretty much everybody. When there's no job and you just want to sit down and draw something for fun, you know, just draw something for fun, who do you enjoy drawing? Who's fun to draw?
I don't really draw any 15. I don't really draw any characters. I mean,
no, okay. Well, what do you like to draw? Just in your spare time. What's
if it's
fun?
Not for a paycheck.
If it's not for a paycheck, what are you sitting down and drawing just for fun?
I know it's kind of sad to say it, but I really don't draw if I don't have to anymore.
Oh, okay.
Because so much of my day is spent. I wake up in the morning and I draw
you work all
until
day.
I go to bed at night.
Right.
I'm not one of the. I know a lot of guys who are really fast, and I'm amazed by them that they do warm up drawings and cool down drawings and all these things on the side. And I'm not fast enough to, the GIMP thinks that's funny, I don't know where they find all the time. If I'm working, it's because I'm working on something I have to.
All right. Well, then when you're not working.
I love drawing cartoon animals. When people ask me to, I get commissioned to do drawings. When people tell me to draw whatever I want to, more often than not, they get Shazam.
Shazam.
Yeah,
okay,
doing something really stupid or corny with world's greatest.
What do you like about Shazam?
He's silly. His best friend is a talking tiger. One of his main villains is a myopic caterpillar with a base on the moon.
Right, so the whole concept is
it's
ridiculous.
It's just absurd.
Yeah.
It's absurd.
Fantastic.
I mean, it's all absurd. All comics are just about as dumb as you can imagine.
but that one in particular has some...
Yeah, this one has no pretense whatsoever.
I love that. Tell us about your current projects. What are you working on right now?
Oh, I'm working on a thing right now that I can't really talk about.
Right, your secret project. We'll have you back in maybe about a year once the big story is broke.
Once it comes out and he gets... I've recently had a graphic novel called Four Norsemen of the Apocalypse.
Right.
That came out about this guy. Can I swear on this?
Totally.
Okay, yeah. This guy who's like a real asshole. He's like a womanizer and he's a Navy pilot, and he's in Afghanistan, and he does something really stupid, and he dies in a plane crash. And because he's of Norse descent, he winds up going to Valhalla.
Oh, right,
and
right.
It's a total sausage fest. It's just all dudes eating, like, meat, drinking ale,
right.
And farting, and it's really horrible, and there are no women around. And because he's an asshole, he pisses off the wrong people. And so it becomes sort of like a Animal House meets Time Bandits, where they try to escape Valhalla and they bounce from afterlife to afterlife trying to get back to Earth so to find pussy, basically.
Well, I think that's a story we can all relate to. Trying to get out of hell, find the pussy.
Yeah, get some pussy. And then there's another an online comic that I did for a publisher. It's an app called Farrago Comics.
Okay.
With a writer named Rob Kuttner, who works for Conan O'Brien, and he worked for The Daily Show when Jon Stewart was on it, and it's called Shrinkage, and it's kind of a take on the Fantastic Voyage, where the president is this dopey sort of George Bush type. You remember when we hated George Bush and now we could give anything
to I would love that
moron in office again. The aliens are invading Earth, but they're microscopic, so they invade his brain. They eat nuclear energy, and so they get in his brain and drive him crazy so that he can. I'm telling you a whole damn thing. There's no point in buying the comics.
Don't do that. Let me stop you right there.
Alien invasion story.
Where can people read this?
The Farrago Comics app.
Farrago Comics
app.
iPad. Fantastic.
It's got some shits and giggles in it.
Very cool, very cool. And now you're out there, you're in the public eye, you're hitting the convention. So when people want to come and find you and have you commission a piece, can people just contact you and have you commission?
Yeah, I'm
a piece
on Facebook. My not at all douchey artist page is John Jolton Johnny Lucas.
And we have a link to that.
I'm on
the
I'm on DeviantArt under Jolton Johnny sure. Lucas.
And so somebody can just, you know, they have an idea for a picture. They want a Spider-Man or a Batman Deadpool picture.
Yeah, ask me to draw something and I'll tell you how much it'll cost and you can say yes or no.
Now, the other cool thing that you do, which I love, is the numbers are getting weird, Bob. I'm confused. All right, so
is this how much time we have left?
Okay. No, there's no time left. No time. What do you just get? Yeah. I thought it was going up. You can see we're a professional bunch around here.
I'm a little on the spectrum, so I'm going to point and see things like that and say them out loud. Like if we were in a car together, I would read off all the signs to you as we're going in.
Now, what I was going to say is the other thing that you do that I particularly love as a musician is you do commissions for band flyers. Yeah. Bands can contact you and say, hey, we'd love you to do a really amazing piece of art that we can use. And you've done, I think we've got a slideshow of some of those from the locally here. We've got, I don't know if the Samoka made the
Pinkish
cut.
Black right there.
Pinkish Black, I saw, did a couple.
I'm originally from Texas and... I lived in Fort Worth for a while, and Pinkish Black is a Fort Worth band that are buddies of ours, and they played Vino's a couple of times. And so just as a favor to CT, who I got to be buddies with locally, mm-hmm. and the guys in Pinkish Black, I would do their posters, and Adam Fawcett, that's fantastic. But through that, the guys at Last Chance Records have contacted me, and I've done some posters for them.
Right, you did the Holiday Hangout poster, I know, this year, which looked amazing.
In Nashville that they did, and then that guy, Bonehart Flanagan, saw the, you know, it's all word of mouth, he saw the Holiday Hangout thing and wanted a t-shirt.
Sure.
And I did that, and it's just been slowly, things have been trickling in. I did a shirt flyer designed for this prog metal band that's local called Samokum.
Samokum, yeah. I'm
some naked broad riding a giant space bat eating the planet.
Well, that dude can't go wrong. We'll see if we can link that in there.
The Kyle Gass thing was awesome.
Samokum, actually, actually we'll try to get them in here. An acoustic performance from Samokum would be really cool.
Yeah, it would be.
But what I really love
that... I can come back and do interpretive dance, like topless, like Hawkwind.
I love that a lot of the Little Rock bands are realizing they can get a really talented artist to do them a flyer, and they can look just as good as, because when you go down to, you drive down Austin, all the flyers look amazing. They all look, it doesn't matter how long the band's been together, it doesn't matter if they're good or not, they have amazing looking posters that really catch your eye, and, I'm not going to say that that's been lacking around here, but this is totally taking that to a totally next level.
Yeah, and hopefully they'll start putting the flyers out in advance. That's one of the things about the Vino shows. I'll do these flyers, and then they're only there the day of. Like the whole point of it is you put them out around town, and maybe people will come to the show.
Yes,
but,
It's
Arkansas. Everything is a little behind, is what I hear.
Well, there is a lost art of putting flyers up. And I will also say... To the defense of bands and the venues, it can be tricky locally to put up flyers. You can actually get fines for putting them up in the wrong poles, wrong areas, or putting too many flyers up. I've heard there's been quite a few stories of that.
Oh, okay. Well, then I apologize for casting aspersions.
No, that's okay. Punk rock bands used to get around it. They would just put the the cross street, not mention the club.
There you go. So I've heard there's some. I like punk music too, and I've heard that there are all these snotty nosed punk kids who have house parties. And if any of these kids out there, if you're listening, if you want an old fart to buy beer and come to the party, then I will happily bring beer to the snotty nosed punk rock.
Holly Rocket, who gave me this wonderful haircut, and I can actually take my hat off. Has a wonderful punk band that I hear maybe just got back together.
Is that the Cunts that I heard?
The Cunts, yeah, and with Bircho on drums. That's going to be a really interesting, very curious lineup of the Cunts that I am impressed to hear. And
Kate's going to be back too.
Well, maybe we can get an acoustic performance from the Cunts in season 2. We've got a yes. You heard it here. You can't take that back. No takes backsies.
Nope.
All right. Bircho, if you're watching, start getting ready. All right. Did we forget anything?
I think that's it.
I think that's about it. No, wait a minute. You just had a part of a New York bestseller. Am I right on that?
Oh, yeah. It's a benefit book that was put out.
Yeah, it was a benefit. That's right.
For the Pulse nightclub shooting. And it's called Love is Love. And
I think we had the cover art there in the slideshow.
Yeah, a bunch of artists, comic book artists, wound up doing artwork to raise money for, I don't even know what it was. They just asked me to do it, and I thought it sounded like a whatever they're doing for the people with Pulse Nightclub, whether they're paying medical expenses or whatever they're doing.
It was clearly it's a good cause, man.
And Mark Andreco, the guy who put it all together, I've known him forever, and he contacted the guy that wrote Four Norsemen of the Apocalypse. He just recently transitioned, and he is no longer a guy. Formerly Matt Sturgis, now Lila Sturgis, wrote a story, a short story that I drew for that.
And, fantastic.
And that's in stores now, and I just saw last week that it was New York Times number one.
New York Times number one. All right, come on.
So I get to put that on my resume now.
Yeah. That always looks good. That always looks good. Regardless, that always looks good. Put your name on there. Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time. Jolton Johnny Lucas. Yes, low count. We don't want you to really leave, so that we have a couch that kind of wants to keep you here.
Well, that's true.
All right. Okay. So before we throw it over to our wonderful band, I just wanted to say next week we've got another great show. We've got Brett McKnight coming in to play some music, and we've got a very interesting filmmaker coming in to talk about some of the projects that he's worked on. His name's Scott Romine. And he was a very close personal friend of James Best, who you'll remember was Roscoe P. Coltrane
right.
and others. Spent a lot of time with James doing a combination of paintings. James would paint these gorgeous scenes, and then Scott would go in and add the General Lee doing a jump
with the
sheriff's car in the background. And they would do these together and then sell these to raise money for, I think, a lot of James's medical expenses and things like that.
Okay.
But they got to be really good friends. He ended up doing a lot of little projects. He's done some stunt driving documentaries with some very famous stunt drivers.
Oh, that's fun.
And he actually shot, and this is what I'm really interested to pick his brain about. Now, if you think James Best, now you have the same kind of mind I do. So let's go way back. I'm not talking Roscoe P. Coltrane.
No,
I'm talking black and white James Best.
Yes.
Is there a movie that comes to mind?
The Beatniks?
No, Beatniks is good, but a little more, add a cheesy sequel to it.
What was it?
Dogs with horrible costumes on. Are you following me? Come on.
You help me out.
Killer Shrews. So there was a fantastic black and white old movie called The Killer Shrews, and of course James Best was in it as our protagonist and shot these terrible dogs with like fur and things on them that were supposed to be giant shrews, and why giant shrews are terrifying is as good as guess as anybody's.
Yeah.
Anyway.
But I immediately go to the Beatniks because of the kicks, man.
The kicks. But guys like us who are fascinated with those old cheesy movies.
Yeah.
A couple of guys like that actually made a sequel and got James Best to reprise his role and be in the sequel. And
no
Scott
way.
Went along for the ride and shot a behind-the-scenes documentary of the whole thing. So I'm sure he's full of stories. I can't wait to hear
some of the stuff. That's going to be amazing.
That's coming up next week, so make sure you tune in. And Brett McKnight is no slouch either.
Yeah.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen, the P-47's!
We're gonna play the song that tends to get us into trouble the most. It's our love hate song with the Whitewater Tavern. It's a local establishment here. Well, I sing about the plight of the working man, the best he can, but it's kind of hard when I grew up in the Heights. Alternative country is the new big thing. Pearl Snap shirts for everyone inside. Got the white water blues, mama. Got the white water blues. I'm drinking PBR like there ain't nothing left to lose. Got the white wall of blue. Well, I drive a Honda Civic cause it's good on gas. Ain't ever rode in a pickup truck. But I sing about the plight of the working man the best I can. But tend to notice like the down of my luck. At the white wall of blues, mama. Got the white wall of blues. All covered up with them damn retro tattoos. Got the white wall of blues. Now nothing lasts forever, ain't that the truth? Nothing lasts forever, Lord knows. The bottom fell out of all this tomorrow. I guess I'd have to drink back a Vino's. Got the white water blues, mama. Got the more white water blues. I'm drinking PBR like there ain't nothing left to lose. Got the white wall of blues. Got the white wall of blues, mama. Got the more white wall of blues. All covered up them stupid retro tattoos. Got the white wall of blues.
True story, all true story.
Hey, ma'am, where can people find you online?
Good God, where are we? We're on Reverb Nation. Go to Reverb Nation.
Yeah.
We record whole albums and just put them on Reverb Nation for free. I don't.
All right, well, we'll put the Reverb Nation link on there. If people are local, where can they hear you?
We tend to play at Four Quarter Bar a lot because our bass player, Jimmy, he works there, so we get gigs there easy. We got some music videos on YouTube and stuff. You can find us.
Will you play us one more?
Absolutely.
Yay!
But goddamn, Josh, I'd like to play a medley of my hit. Well, 1,000 stars are out tonight. I do believe I'll pick one out for you. And if it is a satellite, well, that's all right, I'll pick one up brand new. And then I think I'll go inside, crawl back into bed and hide with you. With a sense of the world's all right, wrap my arms around, hold tight to you. Yeah, satellite. I wish I may and I wish I might, satellite. I wish I was a million miles from here tonight, satellite. Well, now it's Sunday morning, sunlight coming through the yawning, sky's blue. You wake me up with a coffee cup and you ask me what I want to do. My mom's in the kitchen, my dad's playing his little radio low. The world is house, fields full of flowers, where do you want to go? I wish I may and I wish I might, satellite. I wish I was a million miles from here tonight, satellite. Thousand stars are out tonight, I do believe I'll pick one up for me. years I'm past, it didn't last, and now it is a whole nother century. And I need all the help I can get, all the help to forget you. And if it is a satellite, well, that's where I will pick on a brand new. Yeah, satellite. I wish I man, I wish I might satellite. I wish I was a million miles from here tonight, satellite. I wish I man, I wish I might satellite. I wish I was a million miles from here tonight, satellite.
Thank you very much, y'all.
Thank you so much. All right, let's make that a little more awkward. All right, hey, where am I looking? Where are we at? We're over here. We're here, bud. All right, guys, thanks so much for being with us. We're over here. Don't tell me we're over here. We're over here.
Hey, which tree are we on?
I don't know. All right. So, thanks for being with us here at Spooky Talk Show. A big thanks to Velveteen Tombstone, Chris Cockrell, and John Lucas. And, of course, my good friends, the P-47's. Woo! Tune in next week. Next week, it's going to be amazing. We've got documentary filmmaker Scott Romine and a musical performance from Brett McKnight and whoever he brings with him. It's going to be good. Tune in. We'll see you next week. Yes. Bye. Hit like, hit subscribe, all that crap. That's it. Bye. Go away.
It was originally,
yeah, it's on Netflix now.
Oh, is it? You can stream it.